Bam's fighting in about 48 hours. It's already Thursday afternoon. Camp flew by. 7 weeks he was here. It was super fast. He's in great shape. What can you tell fans about his fight this weekend? Who he's fighting? And
he's fighting Pedro Guevara.
He's the interim champion for Mexico.
He's an interim champion right now. He's a former champion, I think, 10 years ago. He was the champion of the world. The kid's got experience. He's 42 and 4. Never been stopped. I think our losses have been pretty close. Very experienced guy, tough guy. But, you know, Bam's in great shape. Bam's going to go out there and do what he always does, man. Put up a good show.
What makes Bam different than any other fighter on the planet? He's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters. Well, I think he was number 5.
That he's very disciplined. When he comes to camp, that kid is disciplined. You know, back home, you know, he likes to eat. That's one thing he likes to go eat. He's not a party guy. He's not a, you know, he eats a lot and buys a lot of shoes, you know, but he likes to eat. There's a few places over in San Antonio that he loves to visit and eat, which is nothing wrong with that. But when he comes to camp, he's all business. For 2 months, all business. And that's why he's already on weight. You guys seen the picture?
He was 3 weeks ago. One thing I noticed about him, Robert, and I noticed it was about Canelo and Pacquiao, even Tank, they come in early and they stay late. Everyone leaves the gym, they're still doing abs.
I think Mayweather probably the same way.
Well, Mayweather trains for 3-4 hours.
Very few. That's why very few like that are special. You've had hundreds of thousands, I don't even know if actually maybe billions of world champions throughout history. But there's very few special ones. Very few special ones.
So how come other people don't have that mentality? If I was a fighter, I would be like that.
It's just the way it is, man. You know, you have kids here, you know, that are amateurs that are dreaming of one day becoming champions, but they already they're already going to a tournament and they're riding in the fucking van and the drive, you know, the coach is driving and they're over here in the back eating candy and shit. They're only doing it to themselves, right?
You had a fighter at your house, a brother of a niece, a nephew of someone famous. And he was eating
my room, fucking,
threw up under the bed
and fucking
eating candy,
paper wraps, soda, everything all over my room.
Well, he wasn't supposed to do all that. He
wasn't supposed to, but that's when discipline, you know, and that's, you know, I'm not saying those online never gonna make it either, because, you know, I used to fuck around with food like that and I became champion. Mikey wasn't very strict, you know. When time came to camp, Mikey was good, dedicated. Fernando Vargas. Come on, Fernando, we had some good times, eh, compa?
Yeah, you guys shared stories at the Big G. I didn't record the stories, but you guys had a lot of stories from back in the day.
You know, training camps. Sometimes I took blame for shit that happened. Yeah. You know,
what happened? Give us an example, Robert. Now it's years later.
Just shit like, you know, shit that happens in training camps.
You took responsibility for somebody else's fuck up.
Yeah,
why?
So what?
Took one for the team.
But still, fighters like that, and you still make it. You know, it doesn't mean you're not going to make it, yeah. Because Fernando was also very dedicated, you know. Fucker trained hard. That fucker trained hard all the time.
He was an Olympian. Same Olympic team as Mayweather and Reed and
he always trained
Antonio
hard.
Tarver.
But yeah, it's difficult, you know, to be like Mayweather. Like
Canelo.
Cristiano Ronaldo. Canelo right now. Fucking, you know, athletes like that. Fucking, what's that quarterback?
The white guy, the tall one?
Yeah, fucking.
What's the name, guys? I'm alive. What's the name of the quarterback that's very famous? They just retired.
Yeah, can't even think of his name.
Yeah, but you know what else Robert? You know, all those guys you mentioned, like Kobe Bryant, he trained like he never won a game.
Exactly.
They train like they never won a. Canelo trains like he never won. Canelo, Tom Brady. Thank you, guys.
Tom Brady. Canelo.
Yeah, I don't watch football.
Canelo has hundreds of millions of dollars already. He still fights and still trains like if it's his first $1 million payday.
Most fighters are not like
that. Mayweather always did that, right?
Yeah, but other
Anthony
fighters.
Anthony Joshua, he's worth hundreds of millions of dollars. Still fights, still trains. You know what I mean? They could easily say, "That's it. I'm done. I'm set for life." And
I've seen fighters come.
This is a tough sport too.
Yeah, and I've seen fighters make one big payday and act like I'm done.
They think they made it.
Yeah, and once your mentality
is. How many amateurs come out of the amateurs and promoters give them $3,000-$4,000 a month plus $100,000 signing bonus?
Thousands.
They think they made it already. Yeah. They think they already made it.
Yeah, it's true.
Eso pasó mucho back then. That happened a lot back then.
They think they made it already. And no, it's not reality, man. You know, they still have a fucking whole career ahead. But it's just the way boxing is.
The fighters need to wake up at 5 in the morning to go running.
Sleep
in. Did you used to do that?
Yeah.
Did you used to do that?
We did it all the time.
5 in the morning. The birds are still sleeping. It's cold outside. And you run 8 miles every morning?
You don't have to. It's better to wake up, to rest as far as you know, your body's going to rest. Because if you went to bed at fucking 11, fell asleep at 12, and they're fucking knocking at your door because you have to at fucking 5 in the morning, then you're only sleeping 5 hours.
Not good.
That's not good. You need wake up. Go to the gym, go run, but sleep good.
Okay, should you eat breakfast before you work out so you have energy or after?
I like breakfast early in the morning, maybe at least 2 hours before. I'm not a fucking doctor. Charles will probably tell
you. Yeah, but boxing has changed. But you work with all the fighters, and you know from your experience.
Boxing has changed, man.
Is it better now or worse?
I think it's better, especially when it comes to cutting weight and all that. I see fighters fucking... Shit,
the money's better.
Right now, motherfuckers drink a gallon of water the day before the weigh-in. Just to fucking drink this much for 2 weeks before the fight.
That's crazy. And you didn't have a concussion?
I used to fucking pass out every fucking, not every day, but quite a few times. Just in camp, 2 weeks, 3 weeks before the fight.
Okay, what shoes did you fight in, you remember?
There was a few times where I used I don't see anybody using them anymore. Shoes that you would buy from Mexico.
Okay.
They used to be pretty high. I liked them pretty high, but the sole was like leather. And when I fought John Molina, I remember, I fought and I won, and it was a tough fight.
He's Puerto Rican, right?
Puerto Rican, yeah. But I fought. After the fight, when I take out my shoes, I'm taking out my sock, and I couldn't. It was stuck to my skin. They were the whole sock and the bottom was red because it was my both were so bloody because of blisters that I got because they were hard leather. Like,
you didn't try them out before the fight and work out with them?
No, that was a problem.
You should try them out for like a week, right?
But even then, even if you have them for a month, they're still going to be hard. So now with the ones they do, Everlast and Nike, they're wrestling shoes. They're really soft, really light. Those are good. Then there's also the ones that come from Japan, Mizuno or something.
Yeah,
those are really.
Emmanuel Stewart loved those.
A lot of fighters wear those.
What about the ring outfits? Have they changed over the years? Are the same? The outfits, the trousers.
Yeah, now everybody. Before, remember Tyson?
Plain black,
fucking
nothing.
Plain black. Or remember every fighter from Kront? Gold with
that's
red.
It.
That they have their colors and that was it. Maybe their last name on their waist. That's it.
Now
they fucking do
NASCAR.
All that flashy
nothing
shit.
Wrong with that. Get paid.
Flashy
sponsors.
Shit and everything, which is nice too. They look good. Fuck. Fucking outfits look nice too. If you have a badass fucking fighter, dress them up nice. Make them look good.
Have gloves changed over the years?
Yes, they have.
In what way?
Because before it was like both fighters have to wear the same glove. Now each fighter picks the glove that they want. And there's so many new brands. There's so many brands that are really good. I personally... My first choice is always going to be Everlast MX. I love those gloves for my fighters because they're soft, they're very comfortable, and those are fucking for puncher gloves. But you also have to put a good hand wrap under. If you're not good at doing the hand wraps, then
you're gonna hurt your
then
head.
Do the power lock or the other glove, not the MX. Because you're going to hurt your hand.
What do you think of fighters fighting in gladiator trunks?
Which one's theirs?
Like the skirt.
The skirt? I don't know. I'm a fighter.
Felipe, you never fought? Felipe used to fight in there.
Okay.
Las pinches faldas. Okay. Gabriel Garcia, no? Gabriel. That's a motherfucker. I ain't going to work in your corner like that. Alexi? Yeah.
Oh, Little Milwaukee.
Little Milwaukee.
Little Red Javi Zamarron.
We told him. No, that's it.
Why did he do it?
Because he didn't know that I like it.
But fighters wear what they want.
Yeah, they wear what they want.
But did it change in the way fighters warm up or fighters, when you were a fighter to today, is it the same thing?
No, because that's some fighters don't do much to warm up. They'll stretch out, do a little bit of shadow boxing. Fernando Vargas used to warm up for like 2 rounds before the fight. Fucking boom, hard punches. Do you want to fucking break a good sweat and fucking be you know, go in the ring like that. But then there's fighters that don't like to punch. You know, it's, you know, everybody's different.
I've seen some fighters barely warm up in a locker room. Shouldn't you sweat a little, Robert?
I think you have to.
But some fighters don't. Yeah.
But not everybody does.
If you were a fighter, you want to come in at least a little.
I used to warm up pretty good too. Not too hard, but yeah, you have to warm up.
You have a shout out from New York on the live.
Nice.
What's up with Milwaukee? The two guys from Milwaukee, I haven't seen them.
I don't think they're fighting this year. We're already close to the end of the year.
Yeah.
But they're both going to fight early next year. I think, because I was told by Top Rank that Milwaukee made is going to fight, but early next year. So we'll see. Hopefully, you know, we'll get them back early next year. So I want to take a couple weeks off, too. I want to have some, you know, after December 13, it looks like December 14, maybe, I might not have any more fights. So I want to take a few days off.